This theorem actually has a name. It was called the happy ending theorem. And what happened was that a woman mathematician, Esther Klein, picked up the problem when she was abroad and brought it back, and Erdős and Szekeres thought about it. And it turns out that shortly thereafter, Szekeres and Esther Klein got married. And they were married until in their 90s. So if I put 5 points on the table here in the plane, so that no three are in a straight line, so that's one way to do it. Or I could do it like this, or I could do it a different way. And what you're looking for, you're looking for a convex set of 4 points. And what does convex mean? Convex means as you're moving around the polygon, say you're going from here to here to here, so I went all the way around the edges, you're always turning left. You never turn right. This is the idea of a convex polygon. A polygon that's not convex is something like this. So if I were to go around the outside of this polygon, I turn right, then I turn left, then I turn left, then I turn left. So it kind of dented in. So you're looking for a convex polygon. Now here's a set of 5 points. Could I have a convex? Yes, here's a convex one right here. How about this one? Well, that's a little harder, but here's one.
You don't have to use all five points.
No, you only get 4 points. So the question is, now, if I just gave you 4 points, like this, then there is no convex foregone here, because you gotta use all 4 points, and so you'd be stuck. With 5 points, you have to get a convex foregone. And there's very beautiful, nice proof of that. If the outside only had 4 or 5 points, then you could use those points and get your convex four-sided figure. But if it didn't, so if you had a triangle and 2 points on the inside, okay? So look at these 5 points. Then if you just take this line and extend it through, then it will hit a side over here, and then these 4 points form a convex n-gon. So the question is, suppose you wanted not a convex foregone, you wanted a convex five-sided figure. If you put enough points down, must you get a five? Yes. And the answer is yes. If you put 9 points down, no three in a straight line, you must form a convex five-sided figure someplace. And 9 is the best possible. With 8, you can prevent it. With 8, you can prevent it. And just very recently, people showed that if you put 17 points down, you must get a convex six-sided figure. And 16 is not enough. So it's a beautiful conjecture of Erdős and George Szekeres, who is his longtime collaborator, that if you want a convex n-sided figure, an n-gon, then it's enough to put 2 to the n minus 2 plus 1 points. That should imply that you would get a convex n-gon. And that would be best possible. There is a way to put only 2 to the n minus 2 and not get one. So if n is equal to, say, 6, you want a convex 6-gon, then 2 to the 6 minus 2 plus 1, which is 17. And that was that recent result. 17 is enough. And if you put n is equal to 4, then you want the convex 4-gon. 2 to the 2 plus 1 is 5. That's our 5. Okay, so it's the guess is that that's exactly the right answer. And I offer $1,000, kind of in Erdős's name, to prove that that's the right answer, or prove it's not the right answer.
$1,000 of your money.
Prove or disprove? Well, I have some, yes, I have some Erdős money left for this emergency in case people solve his problems, right?
So that's not a fact yet. That's just a...
No, this is a conjecture. There are many papers and surveys, and it's just one of these kind of innocent geometrical problems. Again, in the spirit of Ramsey theory, which shows that in a complex situation, there's a certain order within it. And the complex situation is a bunch of endpoints in the plane, and the order is a n-gon that's convex. It was known to n equals 4 was right away, and 5 was done 30, 40 years ago, and 6 was just done, and it used a fair amount of computer calculation, because you have to look at all the different configurations of putting 17 points down in the plane, and there are a lot of different possibilities, and you want to check that each one of them must have a convex 6-gon, and they did, and that's done. But now the next case is kind of beyond computation, so you need your brain. Once again, right now computers aren't up to it for replacing our brains, at least not up to it yet.
That stack is 7.6 trillion threes high. and you start from the top and work your way down, and you get an almighty number. You get a number that is absolutely off the chart.